There's our boy. Looks like he's ready to make some TV magic.
God help us all.
What did you guys do to the RV?
Oh, yeah. It's from our new marketing budget.
Our mobile billboard. It's chilling.
Okay, let's do this. Long drive ahead.
Shit, that is. Hey.
Get over here. It's freezing out here. What are you doing?
Friends,
so you're the little monkey that stole my phone. I've been looking everywhere for it.
Yeah, I wanted to make it a surprise.
Well, it is, sweetheart. Thank you. Come on here. Hey, get inside. It's freezing. Go, 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 go. Hey, sorry.
I'm going to say goodbye.
I didn't want to wake you guys up. I just wanted to slip away. I'm sorry.
Be safe, okay?
Gotta be hard leaving sometimes, huh? Yeah. Sometimes. Phil, how long we got?
About a 7-hour drive. Then we take a boat to the middle of nowhere where we leave you for dead.
That gives me plenty of time to further establish my dominance over my poor younger brother here.
No, is that right?
Well, I've been practicing online, so you better watch out.
Okay, Mom.
Well, that one, I mean, is that really, that's the one that you want to move? I'm just saying that's the way you want to start it? Are we going to trash talk each other in this game? Already over. Smart ass. Okay, so, final location recap. We're going to circle up with our guide about 70 kilometers west of Tomogany. It's very, very remote. Nothing for miles. There's a little hunting camp called Bearskin Lake is the closest thing. Used to be a logging mill. Apparently our guide lives there.
Great.
Topography? Plenty of lakes and rivers, some edible plants, have mushrooms. Be careful.
You eat one lousy mushroom.
Maybe this season.
Let's not have a replay of that.
No, they don't forget to eat something gross if you always love that.
I think you love that.
Yeah, I do. I really do. But the viewers do too, and this is a new audience for us, so.
She's right. She's right. This is our chance to take the show really big. Don't you worry, buddy. Dougie's got it under control. Well, I certainly hope so. There's a lot riding on this.
Yeah, and I'm not ready for a real job.
Thanks for the overwhelming confidence, guy. Oh, you got this. I know. You got it. I'm feeling the love. I'm feeling it. Too long, guys. Days are shorter and shorter. We gotta get out there.
You guys, I'm gonna hit the head. I'm gonna give birth to a calf out of my ass.
Inch. What is up? I'm just gonna talk to somebody about where our guide is.
All right, Bill, you do that. It's a nice town. You didn't have to notice a hospital on the drive-in, did you?
No, you'd be lucky to find a bottle of aspirin here.
That's what I figured. Great.
Hey, look, man, for the record, I know you're going to go out there, and you are going to do a great job. We all do.
All right, thanks, Slim. We getting all sentimental on me now?
No, I'm not. I'm just trying to find a nice way to say it.
There, you spit it out.
Just don't fuck this up. Get us a real show. You know, no more fart jokes, no more goofball stuff for me to cut around. This network show deal might be our chance to make some real money, and I don't want your ego to get in the way of the team. Sorry. I'm gonna go check on the gear. Good chat.
Fuck me.
Okay. So, I found our guy. He just got his breakfast. Just says he needs a little time. Seriously. I don't think our guy's playing with a full six-pack.
Bill, you realize I've got to build a fire and a shelter before the sun goes down.
Yeah. Do you want to go down to him?
Jesus
Christ.
Go on,
do it. Go. Use your star status charm. Get him off his ass. Come on.
You're an idiot.
Go. His name is Duncan.
Duncan?
Yeah. Good on him.
Doug Woods. Real pleasure to meet you, Mr. Woods. Are you a fan of the show? Would be, if I had the cable. Yeah, just that. So, you're pretty familiar with these parts, huh? This your hood?
Wouldn't be much of a guide if I wasn't.
So, any expert advice?
What? For a hotshot outdoorsman like yourself? Heck, nothing I wouldn't tell myself every time I go out in the bush.
Oh, yeah, what's that?
That if I die, a bear will probably find my body way before any search party does. I'll see you on the boat, Mr. Woods.
Duncan, Angie, Carrie.
Yeah, he's doing.
Thank you. This is some engine you got here, huh?
Oh.
Need a shallow draw and navigate these waterways. Comes in real handy in the back lakes during the moose season, eh?
That's impressive.
Only the best.
Same as always. 5 days alone, making TV magic, then we pick you up. Anything goes wrong, we track down the sat phone and haul your ass out of there.
Right? Okay. Ooh. Must be nice to have a lifeline.
Hey. This is what you do.
Right? Hold that.
Hold that.
All right. Bring it in.
Bring it in. Phony knuckle.
Anytime you want to be the guy out here on his own, you let me know, because I'd make a great comedy show. Ass.
Hey, don't forget, eat something gross. Everyone. Well, here I am, in the wilderness of the great Canadian North. My team just dropped me off, and I'm completely on my own. Won't be seeing anyone for another 5 days until they come pick me up. The scenario I'll be playing out is that of an amateur nature photographer who got lost in the woods and totally turned around. And as always, my producers have packed my backpack. I don't know what I'm gonna get. So, let's see what we got in here. We got a hat, a camera, a flash. Oh, that's right. Amateur photographer. Can of Amp energy drink. Apple. Swiss Army knife. And a stick of gum. The first thing I'm going to want to do is hike into that tree line. Once there, I can figure out exactly how I'm going to survive these next 5 days. As you can see,
started building my shelter. I'm using this large fallen branch, and I'm laying in these cedar branches at an angle. That should keep me nice and toasty. The idea here is to make sure that we...
No! Oh! Oh, fuck! Motherfucker!
Oh! Oh! Okay, let's document that. You see that? That's right under the nail. Oh, yeah, day one and I'm already bleeding. Oh, that hurts. 1, 2, 3. Oh, oh, that feels better. I'll clean myself up and get back to my shelter. Hello there. Yep, I just finished this tasty soda. I'm going to show you how to start a fire using a soda can. What you're going to want to do, grab some earth moist dirt and polish the bottom of the can. I've been doing this one for about a half hour. That's right, a half hour of constant polishing. Very good at it. No more fuck-ups. What we do is we place the can in a position so that the sun can bounce right off it, find a sweet spot, and let the sun do its work.
I have made fire.
Nobody cares. I care. Ah, come on. That's cool no matter how you cut it. Oh, I'm gonna burn the camera. All right. More wood.
Hello, fearless leader. Still alive?
Now that I hear your sexy voice, I have something to live for.
Hold up, don't want to talk to you.
Hey, pal. Good?
Yeah.
All settled in, just checking in on you guys. Is that music?
Oh, yeah, it's off Terry's laptop. Hey, I gotta tell you, buddy. Duncan set us up in a primo spot. Angie was off getting B-roll today.
I caught 2 good-sized trout, grilled them up. Now we're in this Angie Scotch.
You know, I'm sleeping under a tree, right?
Nice, buddy.
That's why you're gonna be famous in 11 different countries.
From your lips. Hey, put Terry on. Slim!
Hey. How's today's footage
looking? Pretty good. Some minor fuck-ups to cut around.
Oh, yeah, that's to be expected.
Smart ass. Hey, listen, I've hiked into Gull Lake. I've set up a shelter. I'm going to stay here. So pickup will be the same as drop-off.
Got it?
Yep.
All right. Go back to your little fancy party. I'll talk to you guys in the morning. They're worried about me. The earth shake beneath me. Poof. There's no storm. Yes, it was an earthquake. They're rare, but they do happen. I guess there are no aftershocks, so... Back in a sec. Well, it's day 2 on the Canadian Shield. And even with a shelter and a fire, it sure is nice when the sun comes up. Now the sun will be up. Holy shit. Look at that. Look. It's like a perfect line right down the lake.
got to investigate this. From Wilderness Show to Detective Show. Follow me.
Everything's fair game. That big fat rabbit sure would be tasty right about now. Let's see what we can do. Now, one of the simplest, most effective traps is called the figure four deadfall. And what you need for this is three sticks and a big rock. Well, it's very, very simple. Put a piece of bait just on the tip of stick C over here. Our furry little friend will crawl in all curious and hungry. And with any luck, he'll trigger the trap. And that will kill any small animal. All right, now let's set this up again so you guys can see how I did it. Stick a big rock. Maybe you guys look. Stick A. Stick B. Stick C. You want to make sure the grooves and the notches all line up. Okay. Now, a bait. Rabbits love apples. Now, we wait. All right. I never did anything for him, Angie. Okay. So, this morning, I set three traps. Let's see if we got any food.
Oh, look at this.
Wait for it.
It looks like we got some food. I tell ya, it'll be nice to get some warm meat in my belly. Ah, get it me. Anywhere near where you're sleeping, you'd invite unwelcome guests like coyotes, wolves, bear. What you want to do is take Bugs here, lay him on his back, like this. Take your knife, and you want to make a nice, long cut from the breast all the way down to the belly. Once you've made your first cut, you want to work your thumbs in and under the fur all the way around, kind of like a giant tangerine. Pull it apart, when you get down to the leg, you need to snap it, make a shallow cut all the way around the paw. It should all slide off. Next, a nice slice right from the breastbone down to the belly. This time you want to get deep. And that reveals rabbit innards. Okay, last but not least, sorry, pal, cut off the head. And there you have it. Sumptuous wild rabbit, ready to cook. Come on. Can you hear me now?
Hi, babe. I know things have been really stressful lately. I wanted to give you something to keep you warm and cozy in those freezing cold nights out in the woods. I know that you love it out there, but be careful, okay? And we will be here when you get back.
I love you. Yeah, I'm an ass. So whatever it is, back. That's probably that wolf. Wolves travel in packs, so I'd be lying if I said I wasn't a little nervous. Between a wolf pack and a bear, I'd take a bear any day. Some more food. So, just finished my first rabbit. Delicious. And while I could easily eat the second, it's probably a wise idea to save it for tomorrow. After all, my traps may yield nothing. I don't want to be hungry tomorrow. But I don't want to keep the rabbit with me here at my shelter. I don't want to attract any animals like our friend Mr. Wolf out there. So what I'm going to do is hang it from a high branch out of reach of any large animals. I didn't have any rope with me. That's where a camera strap comes in handy. It's made of a tightly woven nylon and cut into thin strips. It makes a terrific rabbit rope. All right, so I've got my homemade rope with a stick tied on the end. I'm going to try and get it over that branch and hoist up Mr. Bunny. Oh, almost. One more time, hang on. Yeah, oh, come on. Oh, one more time, hang on, we almost got it. That's a shit! And a three. First try. Okay. Okay.
an important and often overlooked aspect of survival. It's keeping your mind active. The isolation and loneliness can drive many to lose hope. As you know, I like to play chess against myself. An extra bit of firewood that I got. I throw a little bit on every so often just to make sure the fire doesn't die. I'm actually really happy with this shelter. And the fallen tree and the pine and spruce branches as a roof. I'm gonna stay relatively dry all night. I'll check in with you guys in the morning. Relatively dry, my wet, cold ass. I hate you guys so much right now. And your scientifically designed waterproof tents. What was that? Shut up, geese!
I hate this so much right now, I don't know what it's for. Come on. Sure do. Hey! tree in the Great Canadian Shield. My shelter served me great last night. Shielded me from the rain and the heavy winds. On the breakfast menu this morning, wild... slipped over the rock and just ate whatever I caught. Let's see if we're any luckier with the other traps. This folks are probably thinking, it's my lucky day. There's food under every rock. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Maybe he felt sorry for me and left me one, seeing as I did all the work. Is gone, and the chess pieces have moved. You know any wolves who can play chess? There's someone clearly out here. I got two more days. That's it. I'm gonna make my way around the lake, and then I'm gonna come up to pick up point. Swear to God, Terry. I swear to God, if this is you and Bill and Angie, if this is your way of teaching me a lesson, of fucking with me, oh my God. I will be really, really, really fucking pissed off at you guys. Thank you.
My spidey senses are screaming at me to get the hell out of here. I mean, crocodiles, snakes, bears, bring them on. But psycho mountain men? I have no interest in tangling with. I'm gonna ditch my fancy digs here and move out onto the cliff. I'll try and get some footage for the show, but this is starting to feel really messed up. So let's assume you've been lost in the woods for several days now, and you're confident that a rescue party is out looking for you. In that scenario, you wouldn't want to be in the dense forest, but out in the wide open, where you'd have a greater chance of being seen. Shelter. The shield will be from the wind and the rain. Now we just have to make it a little cozier. Let's get to it. Home sweet home. Welcome to my new camp. Let's go scrounge up some food now that we've got our fire going. So here I am at the creek, which is not only my new water source, this is also a great spot for finding local food. Small fish, crayfish, frogs, anything buggy. Thank you. I set a 3-camera security perimeter. Asshole sits 1 foot in this camp. Smile, you're on fucking camera. Idea was Northern Ontario. Ontario? Why couldn't it have been Bahamas or Santa Barbara? Surviving Santa Barbara. I'd watch that show. Some food. I'll try and make it something gross for you, Bill. Done, Terry. This is bullshit. Yeah, I can deal with the outdoors and the fucking animals and the weather, but I can't deal with a fucking psycho chess playing lumberjack, Terry. I'm done. It's over. You're gonna have to cut this together and make it look like 5 days in post. I'm gathering my fucking equipment and I'm fucking getting the fuck out of here. All right? This is ridiculous. Fuck you! Asshole. All right, guys, that's it. As soon as I'm done here, I'll pack up all my gear. Come to scoop me up, okay? Best I can do. This one's for you, little girl. Well, I've survived 5 days here in the forests of northern Canada. While the wilderness can be harsh and unforgiving, it can also provide you with all the necessary elements for survival. I've moved myself to an elevated spot with an open area above me, and I've thrown some fresh pine and spruce needles on my fire. That'll create a smoke signal that's visible for miles. And then, the help will arrive. You hear that? The help will arrive. So hurry up, guys. Get off your lazy asses and come get me. All right, enough is enough. Enough is enough.
God damn it! Duncan! Is that you? I know you're out here. Come on!
Oh.
Terry?
Bill, Angie, and Terry are dead.
killed the thing that did it. I don't know what it was. Hundreds of miles from anywhere. In case I don't make it. Joe. I knew the first time I saw you, I was a goner. I could survive the North Pole. I was no match for that smile. My baby girl, I love you
so much, it hurts my heart.
Unknown origin. Not of this world. with order military defense forces. The authorities have been pleading with people to get as far away from the densely populated urban centers, to get as far away from them as possible. And if you manage to escape it, if you can hear me, you're out there. Good luck.
We'll be right back.